Welcome back to Brewers. Today we have a new brewery and a new beer. I'm excited, so let's get to it. That's right, everyone. Welcome on Brewheim to the channel. This is a brewery that my friends and I have gone to, but recently I took Mary there for the first time. And we had a good time. It was a calm day there. And we tried out a lot of different beers, but this one we thought deserved a review. So we got a crowler. We're going to taste it. This is Nightshade. It is a bourbon barrel aged stout.
I don't think that Brewheim does a lot of bourbon barrel aged or barrel aged stouts, right?
Yeah, this was, I believe, their first or second barrel aged stout. I was there a while back, talked to the brewer, and he was talking really excitedly about getting some barrel aged stouts, which, as you all know, I love, Mary loves. So, had to try this while we were there. So no spoilers yet, but we're gonna review it. I'm excited to get to it.
Same.
So that's enough talking. Let's get to drinking. As always with the crowler, it's very important you drink it as soon as possible. Today is the 19th. We got this yesterday on the 18th. So we're gonna drink it. And as always with these crowlers, it seems like they get a little messy, a little hard to pour when they're full. I'll do my best though. We've got a lot of good carbonation on there. I'm going to clean this up and continue pouring. We'll be back. All right, beers are poured. We're cleaned up, so let's go to the nose.
It smells like pens.
What part of the pen?
The ballpoint. Like ink.
I'm getting...
pens.
Toffee, caramel, dark fruit notes. Things that I've gotten in... Bourbon County's barrel aged stout, their base stout, and I really love that stout, and I love that I get the same smells here. This is a pitch black used motor oil stout, and it smells super super good. No adjuncts in here, no extra frills, no nothing else. So that's what also kind of draws me to it. I like seeing what a brewery can do with just their basic stout aged. And that really tells you a lot about the brewery and the brewer.
Yeah, I agree with that.
All right, let's taste it. Nightshade. This is tasty. Caramel notes, toffee notes, basically the nose I get on the palate. Not super alcohol heavy, in my opinion. I don't taste a lot of the alcohol here.
It's weird, because after I took this first sip, now I'm starting to smell the alcohol.
Really?
But I don't taste it.
I get a little bit of that chocolate, those chocolate malts. Mm-hmm. Super good. A little more thin than some of the stuff we're used to from Bottle Logic. Or the brewery, but nevertheless still very, very good. This is a very sippable stout. Really glad we got 32 ounces of this.
I think this is really good. It does change, though, once it's a little bit warmer. So I know we didn't go to Brewheim and chug it and leave.
No.
We were sitting there talking, and I think as with all stouts, the alcohol comes out a little bit more when it's warmer. But this tastes so good. Like, I'm very pleasantly surprised. It's no Bottle Logic stout, but it'll do in a pinch. I'm kidding. It's really good. I'm really, I was really pleasantly surprised to see a barrel-aged stout on their menu yesterday. Yeah. Even though I've never been there before, I just knew, they probably aren't doing a lot of barrel-aged stouts, and you confirmed that they don't.
Yeah, and it was new enough where even the bartender didn't really know it was barrel-aged until I was like, well, yeah, that's what it says on there.
Yeah, yeah.
And it definitely tastes like it is. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is really good. Like you said, no adjuncts, but it's a good, solid base stout.
Yeah, well, you know what? Let's take a little while to sip on it, let it warm up, and then we'll come back with our final thoughts.
And we're back!
Mary, what are your thoughts now that it's warmed up?
It's good.
Oh, okay.
There's more alcohol in it, I feel.
You think so?
Yeah.
For me, I think it opens up a little bit, and I trades a little bit of the coffee and the Wow, the toffee and the caramel for a sweeter, more dark fruity notes. I think it gets sweeter almost when it warms up.
I think, and this is fact because I'm thinking it, that more alcohol, more toffee.
Interesting.
Yeah, maybe.
I'm not getting the alcohol on this very much.
How much alcohol is in it? Why don't you guess? Do you know how much?
I've already looked. Do you know how much?
How many decimal points should I go to?
None.
That's simple. It's 12. Is it really zero?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's 12.
That is correct. It is 12%.
Give me a real challenge. 0 decimal points? That's nothing. I can get that in my sleep.
I would say if you are near Brewheim, if you like Black Tuesday, if you like Bourbon County, this is a good substitute because it tastes so similar.
Mm-hmm.
And right now it's available. I don't know how often they're going to be brewing it, but I certainly hope they have more barrels going on this.
I hope that they make this with adjuncts. This is just going to be their base. Hopefully they branch out.
And even if they don't, I'm not going to be disappointed.
No. Yeah. No.
But I think you're right. This is a great base beer, just like Black Tuesday is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just like Red Eye November is for Model Logic. It's a good base, and it can turn into so many different things. I can see them adding blueberries to this, raspberries to this, you know, vanilla even. Just simple vanilla in here would be great, I think. But this is super good. I'm going to give this a 5 out of 5.
Really?
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah. It's just super enjoyable, super good.
Yeah, and I think, like, Brewheim, the brewery inside is, like, it's got, we were talking about this when we were there, it's got the vibes, like, it's a cool place. And I think most, if not all, of their beer they have there is very user-friendly. So, like, if you're not super into craft beer, you still like anything off their menu. Like, it's obviously, it's not, like, going to be a bunch of Bud Light, but it's, like, so easily drinkable that anything off their menu is good, and this is no exception. Like, I know that stouts are not for everybody, especially barrel-aged stouts are not for everybody, but this is, like, this is something that I would give to somebody who isn't really sure about a stout.
Oh, yeah.
For sure. Like, it's not too heavy, and it's not too much.
Yeah, there's not a lot of crazy adjuncts slapping you in the face. And,
yeah.
Yeah.
I like Brewheim.
Good, yeah. It's yeah. Their menu, they have a very varied menu. They got lagers, they got sours, they have stouts, they have barley wine, they have, if you're not into any of that, you have seltzers, mm-hmm. You know? So, very diverse menu. Loved it. Loved this beer. Loved our time there. We're going to be back soon. And hopefully have some more of their stuff to review. But until next time, we're the Brewmatures, trying every beer from around the world. One sip at a time.